Yo guys, so it was the third and final vlog here in LA. Had an amazing last few weeks. It's been really, really cool. Lad, I'm so grateful for you having me here as well. He's behind the camera, so he'll be smiling away. But in terms of what we've achieved and what I've done, been really, really grateful to obviously be here, to build my brand, to have Lalo as part of that, and to obviously experience America again. LA has been absolutely crazy. Definitely totally different to what I'd expect. And overall, yeah, had a really sick time. In this vlog, we're just gonna go over the last few days on what we're gonna get up to, what's next for the channel, what's next in my training, and obviously a bit more reality, going back to the UK, etc., and then knuckling down, ready for the end of the year. So yeah, let's go along, sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Let's get it.
Yo, so we're currently walking all the way up to the Griffin Observatory and the Hollywood sign, which I'm gonna show you all. This view is easily one of the best views I've ever seen in my life. It's actually quite breathtaking. But yeah, it's quite hot. It's 6 p.m. now, and the heat's still blaring down. Not crazy hot, but it's it's definitely a vibe. But yeah, just take a look at this. Wow.
I'm talking more to you.
Maybe the back guys will find me.
So this is the Griffith. This is the Griffith Observatory, where we've just been in that big building over there. So you can see, obviously, into stratosphere. Inside, we're going to go in now. I haven't been in yet, so we're about to see what it's like. So we're currently walking on the Hollywood Trail, which I'm going to take you up to the sign now, which is absolutely crazy because yet again it's literally like being on GTA, and I know I keep referring to it, but it's actually mental. Also just in my first ever rattlesnake, thank god it didn't come at me. Would have had to like volley Shira, that kind of vibe to get rid of it. Not too sure what my hair's saying right now. It's pretty windy and I'm sweating. It's a little bit of a trek up here. But yeah, this is the Hollywood Trail, and absolutely gorgeous, as you've just seen from the clips already. But yeah, this place is mental.
I used to
up here.
Mad place, crazy.
So that's Century City.
They pay their employees a fair wage. Like, Jesus, never, ever not.
All right.
They look so good.
How do we want to?
You need to figure out which ones don't have the onions.
Or.
Both losing our virginity right now.
Every time. That is
pretty top. So good. Camel Coffee. Korean coffee shop. You gotta check it out. If you're in LA and you're in the east side of LA, check it out.
So it's probably been about, I want to say, 4 weeks. No. Oh yeah, so it's going to be about 3 weeks since I've had my hair cut. So I'm going to go to a barber's. He's my fellow barber. Going to get my first ever American trim. I need a little bit of a shape up. I normally get like a low taper fade here. I do get a few questions on my hair sometimes on TikTok and stuff. So I'm definitely going to try and run through what I get. But yeah, low taper fade. I'm definitely trying to grow the back out, and I want to try and grow the front. But the same, it's like in this growing phase, which I hate because it's just not how I want it to look at all. But you've got to go through that for like maybe like 2 or 3 months. But yeah, that's the vibe. Gotta wait till 10:30 to get it, and we're just gonna try and find something. We've got like an hour to burn, so I'm trying to find something to do for an hour and then go and get my trim. But yeah, $60 for a haircut here. It's pretty cheap. Lalo's used to pay $140 with his normal barber, but I had a trim here yesterday and really liked it, so hopefully it'll be good. I'm not cheating on my barber, I just need a trim. So Will, if you're seeing this, man, I do apologize. But yeah, I'll see you in a bit.
come down to the Art District. Me and my guy AJ, going to shoot some sick content, Instagram, TikTok, photos, bit of video if possible, and see how we get on. But yeah. So as you were saying, the BTS in that then, very much capturing some lifestyle content, which I'm looking to really bring to the page as much as the fitness content as well, just to show that obviously my life is fitness, but at the same time, I do other things outside of it as well. And yeah, it's been pretty cool meeting AJ first time, getting some sick shots, and hopefully they'll turn out pretty good, but you'll catch them all on my Instagram, which I'll link here, and I will see you in a bit. So it's Saturday the 27th of July. I have 4 or 5 days left in LA. Today's the first beach day. I've decided to get a breakfast sandwich and some unbelievable cake, which I'm gonna do a taste test with you when it's time for dessert. But yeah, we're heading over to Malibu later on to go to the beach, and look forward to bringing you with me. Let's go.
Bro, that's so good.
So that is the Josh and Lalo special right there.
So in the next few clips, you're gonna see some BTS that basically goes around us getting new content for Hybrid Hub, which is the Instagram here, hybrid.hub. And it's basically for some brand new programs that we're dropping. We're both really, really excited about it. And I'm really excited to have Lalo as part of that as well. And overall, you guys should be really excited too, because honestly, they're gonna be some of the best that are on the market. So yeah, let's get it. It's currently the 30th of July, so it means it's my last day here. It's currently 6:45 p.m. So pretty got a few hours of it being the last day, and then tomorrow obviously I'll fly home. But I just want to go over just like the last few like weeks, that, and obviously like what's coming next to the channel, my training and what it's going to look like, how I've been feeling recently, what's next basically, in terms of everything. So starting off with finishing the Ironman race project video is out next week. So if you're seeing this on the 30th of July, it'll be out in like August the 6th, August the 7th, whatever time that will be. Once the race was finished, which you'll see everything in the video, and I'm really, really happy with how it's looking. It's one of the best videos for sure, so make sure you check it out. But once you see that video, time between race day finishing and me coming to LA, I felt in a real sticking point, just because obviously I'm not swimming anymore, I'm not riding a bike, I'm not running as much, just because like I just needed a rest. Do you know what I mean? Like the last 2 weeks before the race day, I was shattered. Like every single day I was falling asleep at like 5, waking up to like 11, 12, and then falling back asleep, do you know what I mean? So, and still feeling tired on when I'm waking up. So it was really, really quite strange. But in terms of training wise, I just feel like I'm a bit, do you know what I mean? Like a bit depleted and all of that. But we're back when I come home from LA, it's gonna help a lot. But LA has literally been like a breath of fresh air. Content every single day. We've filmed 3 vlogs literally every week I've been here. So 3 vlogs for each week that I've been here, and that's allowed you guys to see at home what I'm getting up to, and also for me just to document my journey in terms of going from what I used to do to how my YouTube's like come on. We hit 4,000 subscribers today as well, which is just crazy to me as well. I remember in January, I was in Marbella and we hit 1,000 subscribers. So you guys coming along on the journey, Instagram, TikTok, you all mean a lot. But yeah, so that's what basically how I was feeling. Just felt a bit strange because obviously I've got races coming up, which I'll talk about. But in between finishing 70.3 and getting to LA, that period was just difficult. Just because I don't know how to train in that point, or not how to train, but more of the. Like, what am I training for? Do you know what I mean? Like, I like to have a purpose and I like to think, right, I'm going for this. So that's why it's always really important to have a race lined up, which I have done. But obviously, it's just that point in between. It's just very difficult. But what I have learned about myself is I'm going to get back on the swimming. I'm going to do that anyway. I think it's good for your mind and it's also really good for your health in terms of your cardiovascular. Improves your running tenfold for sure. And then after that, we've obviously then come to LA. You've seen everything for the last two vlogs. Hopefully, you've seen those. If you haven't, go check them out. Like, they're pretty cool. And then, yeah, coming home tomorrow at 2:30, land at 9 a.m. In Heathrow on the Thursday. And then it starts to really get good. We've got 9 days left at home in mom and dad's house. And then I'm moving out and I'm moving somewhere else. That'll be a different video and we'll go over that. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. Quite a big move. And then just turning on to training and obviously what's next to the channel. So for me, I've always said, do a 70.3, not too bothered about a full Ironman, just because I feel that's not very hybrid. You'd have to, I was speaking to a guy on the race on the day and he said, if that's what you do, hybrid training, like doing a full Ironman, you'd have to like drop a lot of weights. You'd have to drop body weight for sure, which I don't want to do. And yeah, you know, you can't do the multiple things for cardio that you do. You'd have to just do the bike, swim and the run. And put a lot of hours into it. And like since doing the 70.3, I realized I hate cycling more than I thought anyway, but I hate cycling. Love swimming, love running, but cycling is dead. And then in terms of what we're going to be racing for, so I've said now, you know, it's going to be Hyrox. Hyrox is going to be pushed to the limit. I want world champs. So I want to hit some crazy times in singles and in doubles. I'm going to try my ass off for that. And we're going to get to a point where we are, you know, I want to be up there with some of the best people. I'm 22 years of age. I can definitely do it. And I know I can. My strength and obviously my running can always improve, but they are my two strengths in terms of fitness coming from rugby. And then obviously what's next for the channel. Coming onto the channel is, as you've seen, we've posted a lot of different things before, and then it goes on to the 70.3 prep for the last 7 months, and then obviously these last three vlogs. And then after that, it's going to be Hyrox prep, how I'm dealing with Hyrox, how I'm going to get better for Hyrox, how I'm going to get to the world champs. That is the goal, how we're going to get there. And how we're going to win it as well. And we're going to do many things. And when I say win it, I do mean win the whole thing. That would be absolutely amazing. But in terms of like small wins for myself, is getting to the Hyrox World Champs, is getting to the next stage, is getting recognised as a good Hyroxer. That's got to be the main aim. Obviously, I've done London Olympia, which is a vlog you'll have seen in here on the channel. But I also want to make sure, you know, we're travelling around the world. We're going to go and do Hyroxes around there. And I'm going to bring you guys with me along the whole way. I want this channel to be full of value, full of, you know, you watch it because it's, you know, you can put it on when you're eating dinner, because it gives value at the end of the day. Like, oh, he's never done Hyrox before, he's doing it, so why don't I? When you see the 70.3 video next week, and you know, you'll see how beginnerish I was, and you'll see how many mistakes I made. Some of them are absolutely hilarious. For someone who's done Ironman loads of times, like watching that, you're gonna crease, I'm sure. But in terms of actually watching it and breaking it down, it's quite motivating. You'll see what I mean by all of that. I look forward to seeing how many of you watch it, and hopefully you get as much of a buzz out of it as I have out of a buzz of watching it, just because, you know, watching it back, it's been absolutely crazy, from 7 months worth of work to that day, to it all being over, to the next stage. It's just been lit. But yeah, that is the end of the LA series. Yeah, I can call it a series. It's been 3 weeks, hasn't it? So three vlogs. But that is the end of the LA series. I hope you have watched it and enjoyed it. And just over time, you know, hopefully we can just build more of a bond between, I'm not just some guy making videos. And yeah, I want to bring a lot of personality to the channel. I want you to understand, you know, this is my life. This is what I do. And if you're here for it, then even better. But yeah, appreciate all you guys' support, and I'll see you in the next one.